वेलकम गाइस, वेलकम टू सुपर बायोलॉजी। टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस अबाउट पार्ट टू, रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ का पार्ट टू। एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट मेडिकल टर्मिनेशन ऑफ अ प्रेगनेंसी एंड एसटीडी, सेक्सुअल ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीजेस। एंड दिस टॉपिक इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल। So try to listen carefully and try to understand it and every point of this topic. So let's start the topic. What is MTP? What is medical termination of a pregnancy? Medical termination of pregnancy, it is also called as intentional termination of a pregnancy or voluntary termination of a pregnancy. And why it is called as intentional? Because हम intentional इसको abortion करते हैं and voluntary हमारा मर्जी से हम लोग abortion करते हैं, that's why it is called as voluntary termination of a pregnancy or intentional termination of pregnancy. And this also called as induced abortion. इसको और भी क्या बोलते हैं, induced abortion, legalized abortion, because this is also called as legalized abortion. And MTP was legalized by Government of India in the year of 1971 under strict condition to avoid misuse. ये जो MTP Government of India legalized किया है, 1971 को, it is very very important. ये तो point पे question आ रहा है NEET exam में, बहुत आया है बहुत बार. And MTP has significant role in decreasing population. अगर हम लोग MTP government इसको legalize क्यों किया है, to decrease the population. पहले क्या हो रहा था, जब treatment ये सब इतना medical facility नहीं था, उसके वजह से बहुत सारा बच्चे पैदा हो रहा था. And due to this MTP, we can control the continuous pregnancy. And in this way, we also control the population size. And it accounts for 150 of the total number of conceived pregnancies and legal restriction only to reduce female fertility. इसका सिर्फ legal restriction है कि कहाँ पर female fertility में girls है, जो girls है का death हम लोग नहीं कर सकते, abortion नहीं कर सकते, that is female fertility. And it has the restriction for the female fertility. And this method is safe within first trimester, मतलब this medical termination of a pregnancy can be done within first trimester or within 3 months or 3 months of the gestation period. And after that we cannot do anything. And in which case MTP can be done? First is failure of contraceptive used during coitus or a rape. अगर हम लोग क्या किए हैं, कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव यूज किए हैं, उसके बाद भी अगर प्रेगनेंसी हो रहा है, then in that case Government also legalized for the MTP or abortion. And in case of rape also, government also legalized for the abortion. And second is, when continued pregnancy occurs and due to this continued pregnancy that is harmful for mother or fetus, in that case also we can do the MTP. अगर कंटिन्यूसली प्रेगनेंसी हो रहा है, मतलब एक बच्चा हुआ था, उसका लैक्टेशन पीरियड खत्म होने के बाद और एक बच्चा हो गया, प्रेगनेंस हो गया, देन इन दैट केस इफ देयर इज एनी प्रॉब्लम इन मदर और फेटस, इन दैट केस डॉक्टर विल रेकमेंड यू फॉर द एबॉर्शन. एंड एबॉर्शन कैन बी जनरली टू टाइप्स, वन इज मेडिकल एबॉर्शन एंड सेकंड वन इज सर्जिकल एबॉर्शन. Medical abortion that can be done within 7 weeks of the gestation period, and after 7 weeks अगर हो गया, then we can prefer the surgical abortion. And in case of a medical abortion, the abortion performed by using medicine, but in surgical, surgery is required. This is the difference. Let's discuss. When a woman who is less than 7 weeks pregnant can undergo a medical abortion, if the gestation period is more than 7, then doctor recommends for the surgery, and that is called as surgical abortion. And surgical abortion can be recommended up to 11 to 12 weeks of the pregnancy. पहले मैं बोली हूँ ये एमपीपी सिर्फ 3 महीने के लिए है, दैट इज 12 वीक के लिए, अप टू 12 वीक. अगर 12 वीक से ज्यादा हो गया तो लीगलाइज नहीं होगा ये, और एमपीपी नहीं किया जाएगा. अगर कर रहे हो तो वो है विदाउट ऑथेंटिकेशन. एंड मेडिकल एवर्शन, इट इज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ टर्मिनेशन ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी बाय यूजिंग मेडिसिन और पिल, एंड हियर देयर इज नो सर्जरी. And if medicine or pill is attacking, but you should consult with the doctor or a well-known physician. And surgical abortion, it is also called as a suction aspiration abortion. And the patient is given general anesthesia. पहले patient को anesthesia दिया जाएगा, उसके बाद उसका जो uterine cavity उसको clean किया जाएगा. Uterine cavity is cleaned by using a special instrument and आफ्टर दैट इसको और भी क्या बोलते हैं, सक्शन इवैक्यूएशन भी बोलते हैं. एंड क्यों इसको सक्शन इवैक्यूएशन बोलते हैं, बिकॉज इधर हम लोग को वो फीचर्स को निकाल के, वो जो यूटेराइन टिश्यू को निकाल के बाहर करते हैं सर्जरी, ड्यू टू द सर्जरी. एंड दिस मेथड फॉलोड बाय द फिलिंग ऑफ द कॉट ब्लड वेसल इन साइड द यूटेरस टू रिड्यूस द ब्लीडिंग. अगर ये जो इंस्ट्रूमेंट यूज करके यूटेराइन कैविटी को हम लोग क्लीन करेंगे, उससे वो टाइम में अगर कुछ ब्लड वेसल कट हो गया उसको हम चेक करना पड़ेगा इन केस ऑफ सर्जिकल एबॉर्शन. बट मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट इज सर्जिकल एबॉर्शन कैन बी डन विद इन 11 टू 12 वीक ऑफ द प्रेगनेंसी, नॉट मोर देन दैट. एंड इफ द एबॉर्शन ऑकर आफ्टर 7 मंथ्स, for more than 7 months, that is called as surgical, and before 7 months, that is called as medical abortion. Now we discuss about STD or sexually transmitted diseases. Sexually transmitted disease also called AIDS, venereal disease or reproductive tract infection or RTI. And this sexually transmitted disease that occurs due to the infection of the genital regions. Or so in some case also genital region not get infected, some other organ also infect due to this STD. And this infection in this disease or infection is transmitted through sexual intercourse. It's called sexually transmitted. Why is it called? Because these are transmitted through sexual intercourse. And this STD are of two types. Sexual transmitted disease are of two types. One is curable, another one is non-curable. Okay, curable. Curable STD kya hai? Curable sexual transmitted disease that include gonorrhea, syphilis, chlamydiasis, genital warts, trichomoniasis. These are the curable STD. And the rest of disease or sexual transmitted disease are the non-curable STD, that is hepatitis B, genital herpes, HIV infection or AIDS. These are the non-curable STD. Now we discuss what are the symptoms of sexual transmitted disease. The sexual transmitted disease that shows so many symptoms such as itching, fluid discharge, slight pain, swelling in genital region, and STD that remains asymptomatic in case of female and remains undetected for long. ये female में क्या हो रहा है, ये symptoms नहीं दिखा रहा है, ज्यादा देर तक नहीं दिखाई दे रहा है. एंड वो later stage में क्या हो रहा है, that leads to the pelvic inflammatory disease. ये pelvic inflammatory disease में क्या होगा, वो पहले क्या होगा, vagina को infection करेगा, and that infection that spreads whole genital part or whole genital region. बिफोर क्या हुआ, ये हो गया, मतलब पार्चुरेशन हो गया, डिलीवरी हो गया, एंड दैट लीड्स टू द and this delivery is called as miscarriage. उसको ये delivery तो नहीं बोल सकते, उसको miscarriage बोलते हैं. The ill birth, also called as miscarriage. And next is ectopic pregnancy. This STD that also leads to the ectopic pregnancy. Ectopic pregnancy मतलब क्या है? The development of fetus outside the uterus. Uterus से वो develop नहीं होके अगर और कोई पार्ट में अगर फैलोपियन ट्यूब में अगर बढ़ गया तो क्या होगा? वो भ्रष्ट होने का भी चांस है. That also fatal for the mother as well as for fetus. That is called as ectopic pregnancy. Ectopic pregnancy means the development of fetus outside the uterus. And this STD also leads to infertility or even that further cancer in reproductive tract. And next is prevention. What are the preventions? First is avoid sex with unknown partner. First thing you should avoid sex with unknown partner and multiple partner also. And always use condom during coitus in case of unknown partner or multiple partner. And in case of a doubt, we should consult with a qualified doctor and give complete treatment if diagnosed with a disease. These are the prevention. And now we discuss each and every STD in detail. First we discuss about gonorrhea. Gonorrhea, it is a bacterial disease. Bacterial infection. This gonorrhea that caused due to the Neisseria gonorrhea, and it is primarily known as sexually transmitted infection or STI. इसको हम लोग का primarily initial हम क्या बोलते हैं? STI. And it can be transmitted to the newborn baby during the delivery. This gonorrhea can transmit from mother to the fetus during delivery. It is very very important point. And it cannot be transmitted from toilet seats or door handles. ये toilet seat या door handles से transfer नहीं होगा, किसी को touch करने से वो भी transmit नहीं होगा. This mother से fetus को transfer हो रहा है, transmit हो रहा है. And what are the symptoms? The gonorrhea that shows the discharge from the penis that is white or yellow discharge, and in case of a vagina, white, yellow or green discharge. And that also cause the pain during the urination, also in intercourse. Urination करने के time में pain होगा, and intercourse करने के time में pain होगा due to this infection. And what are the treatment of this gonorrhea? It can be treated by using antibiotics. Usually given in a single dose, antibiotics खाने से ये gonorrhea cure हो सकता है, because it is a curable STD. Now we discuss about syphilis. Syphilis that caused due to Treponema pallidum. And this it is also a bacterial infection. And what are the symptoms of this syphilis? The early sign that may lead to a small painful skin sores in or around the vagina, penis, lips, mouth or anus. Vagina में भी एक तो sore हो सकता है, जैसे कि pimple हो रहा है, and penis में भी sore हो सकता है, mouth में भी हो सकता है, anus में भी हो सकता है. This is the symptoms of the early symptoms of the syphilis. And later on, that leads to the fever, swollen lymph glands, patchy hair loss, headache, and weight loss. These are the later symptoms of the syphilis. And it can be treated by using a penicillin injection, or it can be treated by using 14 days of antibiotic. 14 days तक antibiotic खाना है इनसे ये cure हो सकता है. Otherwise, it can be easily treated with an injection of the penicillin, because it is a curable STD. And now we discuss about genital herpes. Genital herpes, it is a viral infection and that caused due to herpes virus. And one of the species, that is the herpes simplex 1, that caused the encephalitis or infection in the brain, and that leads to the encephalitis. And what are the symptoms of the genital herpes? In case of genital herpes, most of the time it does not show any symptoms. And if symptoms occur, then that includes the blisters around the genitals or anus. जैसे कि हमारा neck region में blister हो रहा है, either genital में region में भी क्या होगा? blisters होगा and anus में also the serous blisters. These are the symptoms of the genital herpes. And remember this, it is a non-curable STD. Genital herpes, it is a non-curable STD. Remember this point. And treatment, yeah, there is no cure because it is a non-curable STD. Next is chlamydiasis. Chlamydiasis that is caused by chlamydia. It is also a viral infection and that found in cervix, urethra, and throat and rectum. This area that gets infected by this chlamydia bacteria. What are the symptoms of this chlamydiasis? That shows the discharge from the penis, that is white or waterish discharge, and from vagina also that shows the discharge like mucus, and mucus that's a discharge hoga, and that also causes the painful urination and bleeding even when non menstruating. Menstruation na hoke bhi bleeding ho sakta hai due to this chlamydiasis, and it can be treated by using antibiotics. Now it is a curable one. Chlamydiasis, it is a curable STD. And next is genital warts. Genital warts also a curable STD. And this genital wart that caused due to human papilloma virus. ये एक curable disease and that one जो viral infection. But हम लोग अभी जितना भी पढ़े वो सब क्या है bacterial था curable का. जैसे gonorrhea, syphilis. Chlamydiasis is a bacterial infection है and genital warts ये एक viral infection है and STD can be transmitted from mother to fetus or baby during childbirth or parturition. जैसे कि gonorrhea में हुआ था gonorrhea that can be transmitted from mother to fetus during childbirth like that the genital warts also can be transmitted from mother to fetus or baby during childbirth. And next, the symptoms of the genital warts that also shows that no symptoms in alistage and the virus clear on its own. ये क्या अपने आप वो virus clear हो जाएगा body में. But several times can cause genital warts or lead to vaginal, anal, throat or cervical cancer. वो क्या करता है genital warts, genital region में warts भी दिखा दे रहा है. And vaginal, anal or throat भी cancer हो सकता है due to this genital wart. This treatment, it can be treated by using cream, gel or solution. जहाँ पर genital wart हुआ है, genital region में cream या gel या solution use करने से वो ठीक हो जाएगा. Because it is a curable STD. And now we discuss about trichomoniasis. Trichomoniasis it is caused due to Trichomonas vaginalis. And the symptoms include, in case of women, that include excessive yellowish or greenish vaginal discharge. Women case mein kya hoga? Yellow or green vaginal discharge hoga. And swelling of vulva and labia. And that also show the painful urination. And in case of men, there is no symptoms. Men mein kuch bhi symptoms nahi hai. Or men mein ye sab ho sakta hai. Painful urination ho sakta hai. Yellow discharge ho sakta hai. Green discharge ho sakta hai. लाबिया मेजर लाबिया मिनर का उसका वो स्वेलिंग हो सकता है एंड इट इज अ क्यूरेबल डिजीज एंड इट कैन बी ट्रीटेड बाय यूजिंग एंटीबायोटिक्स एंड नेक्स्ट इज हेपेटाइटिस बी इट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एसटीडी इट इज द ओनली एसटीडी योर व्हाट हैपेंस नॉट ओनली एसटीडी एस इन केस ऑफ एस आल्सो दैट इन्फेक्ट द अदर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी एक्सेप्ट जेनिटल रीजन. In case of hepatitis B एक ऐसा STD है उसमें क्या हो रहा है genital region को infection ना हो के liver को infection हो रहा है. The inflammation of liver due to the hepatitis B virus. Hepatitis B that caused due to hepatitis B virus and it can be transmitted through blood, semen, vaginal secretion, needle and by tattoo also. टैटू करने से भी हेपेटाइटिस बी ट्रांसफर हो सकता है निडल से भी हो सकता है वैजिनल सिचुएशन में भी हो सकता है एंड ड्यू टू दिस हेपेटाइटिस बी लीवर गेट्स इन्फेक्टेड एंड व्हाट आर द सिम्टम्स येलोइंग ऑफ स्किन व्हाइट ऑफ आईज लाइट कलर स्टूल डार्क यूरिन दीज आर द सिम्टम्स ऑफ हेपेटाइटिस बी एंड If I told you hepatitis B, it is a non-curable disease, but it can be prevent in some situation. अगर जैसे कि एड्स में क्या हुआ है, जहाँ पर जितना तक इन्फेक्शन हुआ है उतना तक हम लोग क्या कर सकते हैं, सब करके रख सकते हैं एंड अरेस्ट करके रख सकते हैं. एंड इधर ऑल्सो इन केस ऑफ हेपेटाइटिस बी फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट वी आर यूजिंग एंटीवायरल ड्रॉप और हेपेटाइटिस बी इम्यूनोग्लोबुलिन. इम्यूनोग्लोबुलिन मीन्स एंटीबॉडी. हेपेटाइटिस बी एंटीबॉडी भी यूज कर सकते हैं. एंड क्रोनिक हेपेटाइटिस बी मेन लीड टू ट्रीटेड अगर मेन बी ट्रीटेड विथ इंटरफेरन. क्रोनिक हेपेटाइटिस बी में हम लोग इंटरफेरन यूज करते हैं. इंटरफेरन क्या है? इंटरफेरन दीज आर द केमिकल दैट सीक्रेट फ्रॉम द वायरल इन्फेक्टेड सेल. ये एक सेल है, ये सेल को वायरस इन्फेक्ट किया है. एंड ये सेल से क्या होगा, दैट सीक्रेट फ्रॉम केमिकल एंड दीज केमिकल इज कॉल्ड एज इंटरफेरन. ये इंटरफेरन का काम क्या है? दिस इंटरफेरन दैट अलो द सराउंडिंग सेल्स एंड दैट प्रिवेंट फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्शन. ये जो सराउंडिंग सेल है वो सेल को जाके इंटरफेरन अलर्ट कर देगा. देखो एक वायरस आ रहा है इन्फेक्शन करने के लिए, तुम लोग तो तैयार होके रह जाओ. उसको क्या करेगा, वो इन्फेक्शन करने नहीं देगा. इंटरफेरन इज अ केमिकल दैट सीक्रेट फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्टेड वायरल इन्फेक्टेड सेल एंड दैट प्रिवेंट द सराउंडिंग सेल्स फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्शन. एंड दिस इंटरफेरन ऑल्सो यूज फॉर दिस हेपेटाइटिस बी. But it is not permanently cured because it is a non-curable STD. Remember this point. Exam mein tumhara aayega. Give example of STD in which there is no infection of the genital region rather than that shows the infection in all the organ of the body. That is hepatitis B. And next is S. S it stands for acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. एक्वायर मतलब हम लोग को बर्थ होने के बाद ये हो रहा है, एक्वायर करते हैं, ना कि ये इनबर्न है. एंड इम्यूनो डेफिशिएंसी मतलब ये डिजीज के वजह से हमारा इम्यूनिटी पावर डेफिशिएंसी हो रहा है, हमारा डिक्रीज हो रहा है. एंड सिंड्रोम मीन्स वर्ड ग्रुप ऑफ सिम्टम्स इज कॉल्ड इज सिंड्रोम दैट इज एक्वायर्ड इम्यूनो डेफिशिएंसी सिंड्रोम. एंड दिस एयर दैट कॉज ड्यू टू HIV वायरस, ह्यूमन इम्यूनो डेफिशिएंसी वायरस. HIV that stands for Human Immunodeficiency Virus and it is a retrovirus. And HIV that they have the RNA is a genetic material along with they have reverse transcriptase enzyme. And due to this reverse transcriptase enzyme, RNA that convert into DNA. And when that convert into DNA, after entry into the person body or host, that convert into DNA. When that convert into DNA, that becomes more stable. जब वो DNA में convert हो जाएगा, वो stable हो जाएगा. And due to the stability of the HIV, we are unable to cure. That is AIDS. And this AIDS was discovered by Lord Montagne and his team at Pasteur Institute in the year of 1983 में क्या हुआ था, AIDS वायरस को Pasteur Institute में Lord Montagne डिस्कवर किए थे. Then what are the symptoms of this STD? Initially, the HIV infection, the primary infection is called as HIV infection. And this HIV infection do not have any symptoms. But when that leads to AIDS, जब वो serious condition हो जाएगा और AIDS होगा, then that shows some symptoms such as weight loss, fever, regular headache, and the spots and marks on face around the mouth. These are the symptoms. And AIDS also एक ऐसा disease है, STD है. उधर क्या हो रहा है, genital region के बाद हमारा body का other organ also affect by this HIV virus. And next is treatment. Here, there is no cure for the HIV because it is a non-curable STD. And this is all about the MPP and STD. अगर ये इसमें कुछ doubt है तो हम तुम लोग comment box में comment कर सकते हो. And please subscribe my channel to encourage me. And next video में हम लोग discussion करेंगे infertility and ART, Assisted Reproductive Technology. Thank you for watching.